In the end, Barry wasn't going to shoot Sarah. They both knew that. Once she had no chance of catching up to Wake, Barry gave up the gun and sat down on the floor, shielding his face from the merciless glare of the well-lit room. "I don't think I'm ever going to see him again," he said in a weak voice. Sarah didn't have it in her to be mad at him. Besides, he was probably right. When I told Barry my plan back in the well-lit room, I'd acted as if I knew what I was doing. I didn't. I was operating on the shifting logic of a dream. I had to fight my way to the lake through the horrors of the night. I had to flick an old battered light switch imbued with childhood magic. I had to write a happy ending to a horror story. I had to save my wife from the dark prison she was being held in.
I will never give her to you.
Zane cut its heart out, but it didn't die. The thing that wore Barbara's face kept crooning sweet nothings sugar-laced with poison. He put on the suit, untied the monster from the chair. The thing in his arms thrashed weakly, but he held fast. He stepped outside, off the pier, and into the dark water, a sinking pinprick of light descending toward a bottom that never came. I could see Mirror Peak in the distance. That's where Cauldron Lake was. Thank you.
Okay, I'm sorry guys, I just noticed again, my mic was turned off. I don't know what's wrong with my mic. So, after Zane had gone, sorry I haven't talked in like in the shifting dream that was the dark place. 20 minutes, I had to find even 30 minutes. Cabin. I'd written myself away through this place in the manuscript. I have to be better looking at the mic.
I'd written myself across the ocean that blocked my way, and with that, there was a bridge to the island beyond. The idea of the cabin flickered in the underwater darkness. I willed the cabin to be real, and it was.
That's the reason why I probably...
The dark place I found myself in was, unlike anything I could ever have imagined. It wasn't solid. It flowed.
It was conceptual and subjective. For someone else, an artist in another field, it would have been very different. I could sense the story of the manuscript all around me, the words and ideas floating in the air, poised to become real.
Yeah, sorry about that. I have to be better.
Turn back now.
Nope. I'm coming, Alice.
Do as you're told.
No. Ow, okay. I do what I want. This is my story. Oh God. That's not true. That's impossible. Okay. Let's take it carefully and slowly. I actually made it directly. Ooh. There we go, that helped.
You can't win.
Oh, flare gun. Okay. Oh. I'm stupid.